In this video, we're going to look at the HTML5 Outliner, a Chrome extension that you can use to better understand how search engines view your site. Let's dive in. Okay, so to install the HTML5 Outliner, you're going to go to the Chrome Web Store. You're going to search for HTML5 Outliner. You're going to get this extension. Install it on your Chrome, and you're going to see this icon here is going to get added to your extensions bar. Then, anytime you go to a website, you can click that icon and you'll see an outline of what the browser is interpreting the kind of the structural outline of your HTML. You'll see a representation of that. So let's go to a website here. Let's go to like apple.com and let's see what Apple's outline looks like. So I'm on the Apple Store, and if I click on the outline, I can see we've got a page title of Apple. And then we've got a lot of sections in here. We've got 25 different sections, and a lot of these things say untitled, but then we can see iPhone 13 Pro, also Pro, iPhone 13, Apple Watch Series 7. So the reason that this is important is because a lot of screen readers will use this outline to convey what is on the page. And so people who are using screen readers will quickly scan the outline to get a better idea of which content they would like to dive into. And then that's what they will use to kind of surf this page, to kind of peruse and view this page. With HTML5, there are certain tags that create new branches of this outline, and they're called sectioning elements. So our body, our main body, is the first kind of main thing. It's the first section. Those sectioning elements are seen here. So if you ever use an aside, a footer, form, header, main, nav, or section, you will end up getting a new section in your outline. If you have divs on your page, divs are not sectioning elements. They will not create a new branch on your outline. Headings are, though. So if we come back to the Apple page and look at the outline, we've got an H1 that is likely hidden maybe behind this logo where they've called this Apple. And then we've got an aside, a nav, and you can see that all of these are sectioning elements: aside, nav, aside, 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 section. If you are creating a page and you don't want to have an untitled nav or an untitled aside, you need to put a heading inside of that aside or inside of that nav. You can give it a negative margin, get it off the page so that it's not visible, but that is a way that you can have a titled and kind of a cleaner outline as you're going down the page. Okay, so let's take a look at a site that I'm building in Webflow to see how the HTML5 Outliner is interpreting that HTML code. This is for Christensen Group Insurance, where I work during the day. We are rebuilding our website, and I'm not using a lot of sectioning elements, asides and sections and mains and things like that. I'm primarily using headings. But I do have some sectioning elements like a nav and a footer and things like that. So if we look in our outliner, we can see that it's just a lot cleaner. You can understand what's going on a lot more quickly. It is easier for the browser to understand. It's easier for screen readers to help communicate what's going on the page. So let's take a look at the White House, which ironically doesn't have the greatest site outline because a lot of their stuff is not titled. They don't have headings inside of their sectioning elements. So it's kind of hard to understand what's going on the site. We can dive in and we can see some of these things that are a few layers deep, but we've got an untitled body, several untitled navs, untitled sections. This is hard for a screen reader, someone who's using a screen reader to really understand what's going on. If we maybe try another site. Let's look at ESPN. We can see that Again, untitled body, not too bad, but then it's a little more clear here. If I wanted to look at tennis or NCAA baseball, softball, I can navigate to these things more quickly, but we do still have a lot of untitled sections here. So it's not the easiest site to navigate from an outline standpoint. Okay, so you might be asking yourself, why does this even matter? The reason it matters is because there's a lot of people who don't view the internet with their eyes. They need a screen reader to help them understand what's going on so that they can surf the web. So having a structured site that is more clearly laid out, it makes it easier for screen readers and browsers and search engines and everyone to understand what's going on your site. It makes it more accessible so that more people can enjoy the content you're creating. After that, it's good to just have a proper structure. If you understand what's going on and you can read the HTML outline and you can follow what the structure of your website is, it's going to be easier for Google and the browsers and the people and everyone else to understand what's going on. So it's good to keep your house in order. All that said, we did look at a few institutions that are really big companies, big organizations that aren't getting it right. So if it's not great, if you're not doing it wonderfully, your website will still work. It just might not be the best that it could be. And why not try to make a site that is easy for everyone to experience? The last thing I'd say is that if you are going to use this approach and you want to clean up your outline, once you've installed it, take a peek if there's any untitled sections, navs, bodies, things like that. Just add headings inside of the sections and then use CSS to hide them and keep them off of the page, off of the screen. So it doesn't have to impact your design. Otherwise, I'd also take a look and just make sure that everything makes sense. Think of these as subtrees and subchapters. And does it make sense how everything is falling in your outline? If things are out of line, then you can use different headings and different sections to try to get your outline back in order. Hopefully that tutorial was helpful and you have a better understanding of what the HTML5 Outliner is and how it can be a tool that you can use to better structure your websites so that search engines have a better understanding of what's going on. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and head over to our website where we have other tips, tricks, and tutorials for your next no-code build. Until then, thanks for watching, and we will see you at the next tutorial.